everybody, welcome back. We're getting closer to Easter, so I thought that we would do a couple of fun things today just to go with some of our other treats that we've done this week. This one is going to be a real fun one. Now, we know that all the kids love Peeps, right? They either love them or they hate them, but most kids love them because it's marshmallow and sugar, so what else is there to love, especially when you're a kiddo? So if you're trying to do the whole self-insisting thing, or if you're just trying to do a lot of stuff on your own this year, I'm going to show you how to make some Peeps, so some homemade ones. Now, there's a great recipe that I use for homemade marshmallow that would be great for this if you had cookie cutters to do that. It's a little, you need quite a few other ingredients to do it. And I do it usually around the holidays. I'll make some homemade marshmallows. It's got gelatin in it and corn syrup and powdered sugar and all of that stuff. So I'm going to kind of veer away from that today. We're going to show you a little bit easier way to make these Peeps, and you're just going to need some mini marshmallows, okay? So what we're going to do is I'm going to go ahead and take a bunch of these mini marshmallows and put them, I have a piece of parchment paper on a small baking tray. I'm just going to make a few of them just so that you can see how to make them. And all you're going to do is you're going to take your mini marshmallows. And we're gonna do a fun design. Now you can do whatever design you want, but we're gonna make, you know how the kids are into poop emojis? You know those poop emojis? Yeah, well, we're gonna make some poop emoji marshmallow Peeps. Okay, so I'm gonna start with four across, okay? And then I'm just gonna build a pyramid. Then I'm gonna do three, and I'm putting them up on end, okay? I'm not putting them the lengthways, I'm putting them on the vertical end, okay? So I've got four, then three, then two, and then one, okay? So that just makes kind of a triangle there. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lay them lengthwise and do the same thing, only this time I'm only gonna go three, two, and one, all right? So what you're doing is you're building a double layer, okay? If you do a single layer with these mini marshmallows, they tend to get a little too thin. Or unless you want them really kind of crunchy and crisp, you can definitely do that. So I'm gonna go three, two, and one. And it's kind of like a little building block here, okay? So you've got quite a bit of marshmallow right there, okay? So I'm gonna keep building these as we go. I've preheated my oven to 350 degrees, so we're gonna let that get nice and warm. I'm gonna build a few more of these, and then in just a second, we're gonna pop these in the oven. So I'm gonna finish building, and then I'll be right back. All right, I've put my last one in, and it looks like we are ready to go. So I have my mounds of marshmallows. Now, this is the tricky part, everybody. This is getting it to the oven without it all falling apart, right? So as you go, even if you wanna take a little bit of water to be able to help stick your marshmallows, just kind of wet your finger a little bit and kind of dab the marshmallow because they're super dry. Sometimes you can do that if you're having trouble with them sticking together to build your pyramid. You can definitely do that. So I know sometimes I have a little bit of difficulty doing them and I have to wet them just a little bit so that they stick together because of that powdery substance that's on the outside of them. So this is gonna go into my oven, 350 degrees, and it's gonna cook for about maybe a minute or a minute and a half, okay? Because my oven's nice and hot. I've had it going for a while. I don't microwave these just because the oven actually cooks them a little bit, so the outsides kind of stick together, where a microwave just kind of like cooks it from the inside out, so it kind of just spreads everywhere. I don't have as good of luck in the microwave that I do the oven. So these are gonna pop in the oven for just maybe a minute and a half at the most. Watch them when they first start to melt together. That's when you take them out. So I'm gonna pop these in and then we'll be right back. Here they are. They were in for just under 2 minutes. Okay, so they're coming out and they're still super hot. So this is what you wanna do. You're gonna take your fingers and kind of poof them back up because they've spread a little bit as they've cooked. They've kind of spread out a little bit. So what you wanna do is you wanna remake your pyramid. Now, it's not gonna burn you, so you don't have to worry about it unless you like keep your fingers on the bottom of the pan too much, but these marshmallows won't burn you. But they're nice and soft, and they've really come together. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna squeeze them in and kind of push them up into those pyramids, okay, into those triangles. These make the cutest little like peeps that, and the kids will love these. It's just a great idea for Easter time, and it's a homemade peep, so hey. Now this week, we've learned to do quite a few different things here at home. Just with the whole thing of just trying to make what we have at home and trying to make things work during this time when going to the grocery store isn't that fun. So if you don't have to go, just don't go. It's a lot easier if you don't. All right, so I made 6 here. I've just got a little mini baking tray. You can actually line a regular cookie sheet up and go for it and make a whole bunch of these. You can make them in different designs. You can do rainbows. You can do like the shape of a bunny if you're really creative and want to build. You want to do a minimum of 2 layers. You can try and go 3. Sometimes if I go 3 and I have to wait long enough for them to all melt together, it doesn't quite work. But I find the smaller the shapes, the better. If you start with a smaller, like these pyramids, they're about the size of a regular peep, you know, that you would buy at the store, especially after you you kind of scrunch them up here. So you just kind of keep moving them so that they don't spread out. Because what you're trying to create is that nice gooey layer inside. That's why you're kind of scrunching these back up together, okay? Some people have asked in the past, like, well, why do you keep doing that? It's like, well, because if you don't, they'll lay flat and then they're too crunchy. There's no gooey marshmallow on the inside, and that's definitely what you want. All right, so I'm gonna let these set for just a few minutes and finish cooling off, and then to just kind of combine together and make one solid marshmallow. Okay, so in the meantime, I've got to make my sugar covering to make them look like poop emojis, right? So, what do you think? You're thinking like, okay, brown food coloring would work great with sugar. If you have that, then use it, okay? Or you can turn these into chocolate peeps, and that's what I'm gonna do today, is turn them into chocolate peeps. So, I've got 1/4 cup of regular granulated sugar right here in my bowl. And then to that, I'm gonna add 1 teaspoon of baking cocoa. And this is just the regular, you know, Hershey's baking cocoa. You don't have to be totally exact with it, all right? So just 1 teaspoon should do it. Or what you could do if you don't wanna do the chocolate thing, say, you know, there are kids out there that don't like chocolate, and that's completely cool. I'm a chocoholic, so anything chocolate I can make is, I'm a happy camper. So you can also use brown sugar if you want to. And again, folks, if you don't have brown sugar in your house, but you have white sugar and you have some molasses, that's all brown sugar is. You're gonna take 1 cup of granulated sugar and 1 tablespoon of molasses. And you're gonna put the molasses in with the sugar and just mix it with a fork. Now, if that becomes light brown sugar. If you want dark brown sugar with the more molasses-y taste, you're gonna put 2 tablespoons in, okay? So 2 tablespoons to 1 cup. Now, with this only being 1/4 of 1 cup of sugar, you can break that down if you need to make that brown sugar and just reduce that amount, okay? So you're only gonna need, you know, maybe like, what is there, 3? I can't remember, is it 3 teaspoons or 2.5 teaspoons to 1 tablespoon, something like that? So you can kind of just break that down and go from there. And like I said, it doesn't have to be exact because you're not baking it. This is just merely for color, okay? So now that that is mixed, I'm gonna kind of switch over to my spoon and just kind of get all of the white sugar combined with the baking cocoa. And this has a nice brown color to it. And it's gonna have a nice chocolate flavor too. So these are gonna be chocolate peeps.